The mind is actually very, mind thinks it is very clever, but the mind is actually quite foolish at times. The mind thinks that the problem is not the indulgence. The problem is the consequence of the indulgence. If I can somehow be clever enough to avoid the consequence, then there's no problem in the indulgence. So, I once saw a traffic joke it was. The person was caught speeding. And was caught speeding, the cop said, "Did you not see the speed limit?" This person said, "Yes, cop, I saw the speed limit. I just didn't see you." So, the idea is that actually speeding is not the problem. Getting caught while speeding is the problem. So what is happening? The mind is thinking that if I can indulge without getting the consequence, then there's no problem in it. So now, why may somebody be speeding? Because they have a need for adventure. They want to make heads turn. They want to get a sense of admiration. Now, many words which were traditionally negative, now they have got positive connotations. There is a word which is called a speed demon. A speed demon means somebody who drives extremely fast. As a demon possessed you, why are you driving so fast? But many young people consider that complimentary. I'm a speed demon. They think that I want to drive fast. But yes, just see how fast I can drive. So I was in London, I gave a class, and there's some tricky questions were there. So I answered the question. So the devotee who had organized the program, he just came out of the program and he says, "Hey, you killed it." What did I kill? I was wondering, did I sit on some creature and kill it? So actually, "you killed it" is a compliment coming from a hunting context. You know, an animal is running, "Hey, you shot it, you killed it. Congratulations." So now, so "you killed it." I didn't want to kill anyone. But the word "killing" normally has a negative connotation. But in certain contexts, it may get a positive connotation. So the word "speed demon," it nowadays has a positive connotation. Some people, they speed not just because they want to get to a particular place quickly. They speed because they have a need for adventure. And if that need for adventure is not addressed in some constructive way, then they will keep trying to find some way to fulfill that need. And if speeding is the way to do it, they will do it. Just telling them, "You can meet with an accident and this will happen, that will happen." They'll say, "No, I'll take care. I will enjoy, there will be no accident." So there's a daredevilish attitude that comes up. And when the daredevilish attitude is there, then even if the unhealthy expression is there, still somehow the mind thinks that I can get away with it. If you look at the history of smoking, initially when cigarettes started becoming popular, at that in the 1920s, 1930s, initially the harmful effects of smoking were not known. And when the harmful effects started coming to be known, the cigarette companies tried to suppress those results. Tried to prove that this is caused basically by smoking, it could be caused by so many other things. They tried to suppress the results. But eventually, when the results became so undeniable that they just thrust themselves into public domain, then the cigarette companies changed the tack. And they started advertising cigarette as a symbol, cigarette smoking, as a symbol of a macho man, of a person who is fearless, who embraces danger, who is a hero. And just as a hero takes dangers to do various things, similarly, take the danger of smoke. And paradoxically, for several years after the mandatory announcement came, mandatory note that cigarette smoking is injurious to health, actually cigarette sales increased. they didn't decrease. Yeah, it's injury, yes, but it won't injure me. I'm a hero. So that need for standing out, the need for looking cool, that need for being heroic, for appearing heroic, that need was being served by cigarette smoking. And unless that need is addressed, that cigarette smoking, tell them, don't do this, it will not work. So what happens with us is that when our mind can misdiagnose and make us misunderstand in different ways. One way is that even when something is bad, the mind says, it won't affect you. It won't affect you. And we continue the indulgence. That's one way the mind makes us misunderstand, that we think that, yeah, this happens, but I am an exception. It won't happen to me. Other is that when we resolve to do something and we are unable to do it, then the mind makes us think, you are so fallen. You have no spine. You have no willpower. You never keep your word. You are useless. And in this way, the mind beats us down again. So the idea that I can get away with whatever enjoyment I want to do and there'll be no consequence, that idea comes from the mode of passion, where I think that I am the enjoyer, and if I'm just clever enough, then I can enjoy.